Congratulations on making it up Pikes Peak.
Thank you
for
very much.
First time. Tell us about your run.
My run was interesting. I finally got to take the three sections and link them all together. And your thoughts, you have to be quick on the thoughts, and a little bit of fatigue kicks in, and your thoughts get a little bit flustered, but you know, you forget about it and you move on to the next turn, and trying to catch them all up. Sometimes I got a little bit behind myself, but then I caught up. But in all, I managed to pull together because enough practice runs that we did allow me to at least be comfortable everywhere I was. And a bit of fear kicked in here or there. I did overbreak in some places, over slow, slip and slide a few places, but nothing drastic. But enough to, you know, not make the run completely clean, but enough to be satisfactory for my first time. I mean, I'm not mad at anything I did. I did it on sake this is my first time.
Wonderful. Weather factor, any weather, road issues?
Once I saw the drops of rain coming down in the bottom part, I said, uh-oh, I'm going to be that guy who gets the first kiss of rain, and that's going to really hurt my time. But I powered through it, and it didn't have a chance to soak the asphalt completely until I probably got to the end of the first section, and I got into a bit of slippy, slidey areas, but not bad, not catastrophic. So, and then it went away for the next section. It was pretty much gone, few drops, no big deal, not enough to make an excuse. So it was good. I was lucky. I was like, okay, this is that's about as much rain as I want to deal with for this run. And when I got up to here, the visibility was good, the traction was good, so the weather, it wasn't too bad for me. So it could have been worse, but I'm happy with it.
So this is a challenging course, 156 turns. What do you feel is the most challenging part of coming up here?
The biggest challenge for me is the danger aspect. I mean, you know, there's a lot of places where you know you can drive a fast corner, but you just always got to be aware and safety conscious of, you know, there's sometimes never a plan B in those sections, so you really got to be careful. So that there is something it's always in the back of your head. I mean, no matter how aggressive or how you like before you want to attack the corner, there's always that element of risk you always have to be conscious about.
Tell us about your car.
This is my car. I'm the owner of it. I bought it new. Very excited when it was coming out. I had to have one, and to get one, you had to get it join a race series, which I was all about. I'm doing it. And this is my third year racing it, and it's allowed me to progress through circuit racing and get myself up to speed and up to pace really, really well. And it's allowed me to actually be here and actually to drive here half decent. So the car's really been a good friend of mine for the 3 years, and we've done a lot together. So it's been good to me, and I love the car. So it's a great car. I've had a lot of adventures with it, and I think I'm going to have to keep this one forever.
Sounds like a good plan. Do you have anything you want to add?
Just basically everything I've learned in driving a car has gotten me to this point, gotten me to here, and what I've learned from here is going to take me further forward.
Those are wonderful words. Well, thank you so much. Congratulations on making it up, and hopefully we'll see you next year.
Yeah, hopefully.
All right. Thank you.